The sun, a blazing star, provides light and warmth. It's essential for life on Earth, but the sun also emits ultraviolet UV radiation. UV radiation is powerful and can damage our skin. Too much UV exposure can lead to sunburn, premature aging, and even skin cancer. Our skin, our largest organ, acts as a barrier. It protects us from the elements, including the sun's rays. However, our skin needs help. It needs protection from the harmful effects of UV radiation. This is where sunscreen comes in. Sunscreen is a crucial tool. It helps us enjoy the sun safely. It absorbs or reflects UV radiation, minimizing the amount of radiation that penetrates our skin. By doing so, sunscreen helps prevent sunburn, premature aging, and skin cancer. Knowing how sunscreen works is important. Understanding its manufacturing process is fascinating. Join me as we delve into the world of sunscreen. Let's explore the science and secrets behind this summer essential. The concept of sun protection is not new. Ancient civilizations used various methods. They used oils, extracts, and even mud to shield themselves from the sun. However, the sunscreen we know today has a more recent history. In the early 20th century, scientists began to understand UV radiation. They recognized its harmful effects on the skin. This led to the development of the first sunscreen products. These early versions were far from perfect. They were often messy and not very effective. One pivotal moment came in 1938. A Swiss chemist named Franz Greiter experienced severe sunburn. This inspired him to create a more effective sunscreen. His creation was called Gletscherkreme, or Glacier Cream. This marked a significant step in sunscreen development. Over the decades, sunscreen formulas have evolved. They have become more sophisticated, more effective, and more user-friendly. Today, sunscreen is an essential part of many people's daily routines. It plays a crucial role in protecting our skin from the sun's powerful rays. Sunscreen is a marvel of modern science. It contains special ingredients. These ingredients, called active ingredients, are the key to sun protection. They work in different ways to shield our skin from UV radiation. There are two main types of active ingredients in sunscreen. These are mineral filters and chemical filters. Mineral filters like zinc oxide and titanium dioxide act as physical blockers. They sit on top of the skin and reflect UV rays away. Chemical filters, on the other hand, absorb UV radiation. They work by absorbing UV rays and converting them into heat. This heat is then released from the skin. Examples of chemical filters include oxybenzone, avobenzone, and octinoxate. Each type of active ingredient has its own strengths and weaknesses. Mineral filters are generally considered to be gentler on the skin and more environmentally friendly. Chemical filters, however, tend to be more lightweight and easier to rub in. The choice of active ingredients in a sunscreen product depends on various factors. These factors include the intended SPF level, the target audience, and environmental considerations. While active ingredients are the stars of the sunscreen show, they don't act alone. Sunscreen formulations also contain inactive ingredients. These ingredients play crucial supporting roles. They help to improve the texture, stability, and effectiveness of the product. Inactive ingredients in sunscreen can include emollients. These ingredients, like oils and butters, help to moisturize and soften the skin. They make the sunscreen feel smooth and pleasant to apply. Emulsifiers. These ingredients help to combine the oil and water components of the sunscreen. They prevent the ingredients from separating and ensure a consistent texture. Preservatives. These ingredients help to prevent the growth of bacteria and mold in the sunscreen. This is essential for maintaining the product's shelf life and safety. Fragrances and colors. These ingredients are added to enhance the sensory experience of using the sunscreen. They can make the product smell more appealing or give it a more attractive color. The selection of inactive ingredients is just as important as the selection of active ingredients. Formulators carefully choose inactive ingredients. They ensure that the final product is safe, effective, and enjoyable to use. The manufacturing of sunscreen is a complex process. It involves precise measurements, controlled environments, and rigorous quality control. The journey from raw materials to finished product is a fascinating one. The first step in the manufacturing process is to combine the active ingredients with a portion of the inactive ingredients. This mixture is then heated and stirred until it forms a uniform paste. This paste is then cooled and passed through a mill. The mill grinds the particles into a fine powder. Next, the remaining inactive ingredients are added to the powder. This mixture is then heated and stirred again until it forms a smooth and consistent liquid. This liquid is the sunscreen base. It is then transferred to large holding tanks. From the holding tanks, the sunscreen base is pumped into filling machines. The filling machines dispense the sunscreen into individual bottles or tubes. The bottles or tubes are then capped, labeled, and packaged for distribution. Quality control is paramount in sunscreen manufacturing. Every batch of sunscreen undergoes rigorous testing. This ensures that it meets strict safety and efficacy standards. Only sunscreen that passes these tests is released to the market. Sunscreen is tested for various parameters, including sun protection factor, SPF. This test measures the sunscreen's ability to protect the skin from UVB rays, which cause sunburn, broad spectrum protection. This test determines whether the sunscreen protects against both UVA and UVB rays. UVA rays cause premature aging, while UVB rays cause sunburn. Water resistance. This test measures how long the sunscreen remains effective after being exposed to water. Stability. This test evaluates how well the sunscreen maintains its effectiveness over time and under different storage conditions. Once the sunscreen has passed all the necessary quality control checks, it is ready for packaging. Packaging plays a crucial role in preserving the sunscreen's integrity and extending its shelf life. Sunscreen is only effective if it is used correctly. Here are some tips for applying sunscreen safely and effectively. Apply generously. Use a liberal amount of sunscreen on all exposed skin. Most adults need about an ounce of sunscreen, or enough to fill a shot glass, to cover their entire body. Apply evenly. Spread the sunscreen evenly over the skin. Don't forget to cover often missed areas like the ears, neck, and tops of the feet. Apply early. Apply sunscreen at least 15 minutes before going outside. This gives the sunscreen time to absorb into the skin. Reapply regularly. Reapply sunscreen every 2 hours, or more often if swimming or sweating. By following these simple tips, you can help ensure that you're getting the most out of your sunscreen. Sunscreen use varies widely around the world. In some cultures, sunscreen is an essential part of daily life. In other cultures, it is used less frequently. These differences can be attributed to a variety of factors, including climate, cultural norms, and skin cancer risk. In many Western countries, sunscreen use is widespread. This is due in part to high rates of skin cancer and a cultural emphasis on tanning. In many Asian countries, however, sunscreen use is less common. This is partly because of lower skin cancer rates and a cultural preference for lighter skin tones. Despite these differences, sunscreen use is increasing globally. This is due to growing awareness of the dangers of UV radiation and the availability of more effective and user-friendly sunscreen products. The science of sunscreen is constantly evolving. Researchers are working to develop new and innovative sun protection technologies. These technologies aim to provide even better protection from the sun's harmful rays. Some of the exciting developments in sunscreen technology include DNA repair enzymes. These enzymes help to repair DNA damage caused by UV radiation. Antioxidants. These molecules help to neutralize free radicals, which are harmful molecules that can damage skin cells. Wearable sensors. These devices can track UV exposure and alert users when it's time to reapply sunscreen. These innovations hold great promise for the future of sun protection. They have the potential to significantly reduce the incidence of skin cancer and other sun-related skin damage. Sunscreen is more than just a bottle of lotion. It's a passport to enjoying the outdoors safely and comfortably. It's a testament to human ingenuity and our desire to protect ourselves from the elements. So the next time you reach for that bottle of sunscreen, take a moment to appreciate the science and history behind it. And remember, by using sunscreen wisely, you're taking an important step in protecting your skin and your health.